skin. We know that we have five sense organs, namely eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin. Now let us discuss about skin. There is one system that extends over the entire surface of our body, known as the integumentary system. It consists of the skin, hair, and nails, which together cover and protect the other body systems against the outside world. Our skin is just a millimeter thick, yet it makes up the largest organ in the body, accounting for around 16% of our weight. Skin is the body's largest organ. It covers the whole body. It contains cutaneous receptors for touch. It protects our internal organs from infection and injury. Our skin is the sense organ for touch, temperature, and pressure. The skin consists of three main layers called epidermis, dermis, and hypodermis. Let us discuss about each layer of the skin. Epidermis. It is the outermost layer of skin. It is thin protective covering. It is made up of dead scaly cells. It provides a waterproof barrier and creates our skin tone. It has sweat pores and small hairs. Epidermis contains three layers, namely outer stratum corneum or cornified layer, that is containing dead cells, middle granular layer containing living cells, inner Malpighian layer containing the cells dividing constantly. Picture of skin. Epidermis. Thin protective outer layer of skin. Sweat pore. Watery sweat is released from small pores to cool the skin. Sweat appears from this opening of the sweat gland. Hair. Millions of short hairs grow out of the skin's surface. Skin flakes. Dead cells fall off the skin as flakes. Cornified layer. The skin's outer layer is mostly dead and dying keratin-filled cells. Dying layer. Cells harden and die in the middle of the epidermis. Skin renewal. The skin is renewed by new cells pushing to the surface where they flatten and die, turning into tough keratin. Base layer. New skin cells are formed in the base of the epidermis, ready to move up to the surface. Free nerve endings are sensory receptors. Sensory nerves run into the epidermis. They sense heat, cold, touch, and pain. Picture showing layers of epidermis. Dermis. Dermis lies below the epidermis. It made up of elastic connective tissue. It contains sweat glands, sebaceous glands, hair follicles, blood vessels, and various types of nerves. Various types of nerve ending sensitive to touch, heat, pressure, cold, and pain. Sweat glands. These coiled glands are not of tubes, make sweat and ooze moisture onto the skin surface where it evaporates to keep the body cool. Oil gland produce an oily substance called sebum to soften hair and skin. Oil glands sometimes get blocked and swell up, creating a pimple. Hair follicle. Hair grows out of pockets or pits called follicles. Hair muscle or erector muscle. This tiny muscle pulls hair upright when the body is feeling cold. Papillae. The top of the dermis is shaped into bumps called papillae. These help bind the epidermis and dermis together. Hypodermis. It is the innermost or deepest and thickest layer of skin. It also known as the subcutaneous layer or subcutaneous tissue. Contains the cells known as fibroblast, adipose tissue, that is fat cells, connective tissue, large nerves and blood vessels and macrophages cells, which are part of the immune system and help keep our body free of intruders. Picture showing hypodermis or fat layer. Nerves. This network carries signals between touch receptors and the brain. Blood vessels. Nutrients and oxygen are brought to the skin by a network of fine blood vessels. Thank you, friends.